ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ವಾಣಿಜ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಕೈಗಾರಿಕಾ ಮಹಾಸಂಸ್ಥೆ, ಫೆಡರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಚೇಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. 14th ಎಡಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್ 2019. FKCCI acknowledges the support of Diamond Sponsor Canara Bank, Co-Sponsors New Mangalore Port Trust, Deutsche Bank, ECGC, Citibank,
This evening is dedicated in recognizing the meritorious performance of our exporters. To give away the welcome address, I now request Sri P.V. Rai, Chairman Exports Committee, to give away the address.
Ellarigu namaskara. Sri K.J. George, Honorable Minister, Large and Medium Industries. Sri J.V. Patil, ITS, Additional Director General of Foreign Trade. Sri N. Lakshmi Narayana, General Manager, Canara Bank. Sri Sudhakar S. Shetty, President, FKCCI. Sri C. R. Dhanardana, President Elect. Sri Sundar Perikal, Senior Vice President Elect. Sri K. Ravi, Dr. Sri H. S. Prasad, Secretary General, FKCCI. Past Presidents, Managing Committee Members, Members of FKCCI, Members of Export Committee, Distinguished Invitees, Jury Members, Award Winners, Sponsors and Friends from the Press and Electronics Media. Good evening. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the 14th edition of Export Excellence Awards. Honorable Minister, Sri K.J. George has accepted to be our chief guest this evening. He is a very industrial friendly person. As soon as he took over as Minister of Large and Medium Scale, Medium Industries, he had an interaction meeting with all the stakeholders to address the challenges faced by the exporters and gave direction to his officers for necessary action on priority. Karnataka government has an important role to play in India's exports, and it is very appropriate to have you as our chief guest, sir, today. And I welcome you, sir. Now I request our president to welcome our chief guest in our traditional way. J.V. Patil, ITS, Additional DGFT, Bangalore, a down-to-earth and easily approachable person who encourages exporters of the region. When we ask the exporters to rate the export facilitating organizations, DGFT was rated as number one. Congratulations to you, sir, on that, and welcome to you. Now I request our president to welcome you. I would like also to welcome Sri N. Lakshmi Narayana, General Manager, Canara Bank. Canara Bank has been always supportive of all our programs at FKCCI. Thank you very much, sir, for that, and I welcome you as well. Indian exports in 2018-19 was $331 billion, which was 9.2% higher than previous year, whereas imports shot up to $507 billion, resulting in a trade deficit of $176 billion. So we still have a lot of ground to cover to bring down the trade deficit. Karnataka's share of exports last year was at 12.7% of India's total exports, which makes it the third largest state after Maharashtra and Gujarat. Though it is an impressive performance, as one of the most industrialized states in the country with infrastructure, strong talent pool and proactive policies, Karnataka has the potential to double its share in the country's exports. I am delighted that we are holding 14th edition of annual flagship event, Export Excellence Awards. The aim of conferring this award is to acknowledge the exemplary work of our exporters and recognize their outstanding contribution to the economy in terms of wealth and job creation, and most of all, contributing to reducing the country's trade deficit. Recognizing the meritorious performance of exporters every year is one of the FKCCI's most coveted events, where exporters not only get recognition for their performance, but also get the opportunity to network with other leading exporters, facilitators, key government officials and sponsors. The award also encourages exporters to strive for success in highly competitive global market, overcoming all challenges and uncertainties. We had received a good number of nominations, and the jury represented by EGFT, FIO, ECGC, NSIC, VTPC and honorary councils, under the chairmanship of Sri J.V. Patil, additional DGFT, chose the awardees under various categories. This year, I am pleased to note that 23 awardees, that is around 50% of the districts of Karnataka.
Before I close, as chairman of the Exports Committee, I take this opportunity to thank all the Export Committee members for their active participation and valuable inputs. My thanks to jury members who have shared their expertise in selecting the awardees. I thank past President J.R. Bangera, who has been our advisor throughout this process. I take this opportunity to thank Sri S. Sudhakar Shetty, our President, for giving the opportunity to serve as chairman of the committee. Thank you, sir. And all the office bearers for their guidance from time to time. Also, I would like to thank FKCCI Secretary for the support provided all through the year. Congratulations to all the awardees and participants, and wish them a greater success in the coming years. Welcome once again to you all.
I think we should not stop clapping. Thank you so much, sir. Someone has rightly said, if you light a lamp for someone else, it will also brighten your path. I now request all the dignitaries on the dais to please come forward for lighting of the lamp. I now request Shri Sudhakar S. Shetty, President FKCCI, to come forward for the presidential address. Please, sir.
Namaste, Sri K.J. George, Honorable Minister for Large and Medium Scale Industry, Government of Karnataka, J.V. Patil, Additional DGFT Bangalore, N. Lakshmi Narayan, General Manager, Canara Bank, C.R. Janardhan, President-elect, Perikal Sundar, Senior Vice President-elect, K. Ravi, Immediate Past President, P.V. Rai, Chairman, Export Committee, H.A.C. Prasad, Secretary General, Respected Past President, number of a very senior Past President with us, K. Ramesh, K. Ramaswamy, Sampatraman, Dinesh, our advisor, Bangera, Babana, Krashta, my leader, sir, our Lewis, Dr. Lewis, and number of, we have the very eminent scholars here with us, Mr. His Excellency, Mr. Mohan Suresh, Mr. His Excellency Krishna, Ravi Kumar NSIC, and S.R. Satish VTPC, my good friend Dr. Anup Dayanand Sahu, and all the members of the FKCCI, today's awardees, ladies and gentlemen, friends from print and print media, good evening to you all. Dear friends, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the FKCCI Export Excellence Award 2019, which is organized for the 14th year successfully. am thankful to see K.G. Judge, sir, for taking time out of his busy schedule to be the chief guest of today's flagship event. Sri K.J. Jag has the vision of the development of Karnataka. When we approached the Honorable Minister at the time of ASEAN meet, the Honorable Minister motivated, supported and stood behind the FKCCI till the program was grand success. I would like to state that because of his initiative, FKCCI conducted the international event at Bangalore. Many review meetings, follow-up meetings were held with the officials and investors, and we are lucky to get huge investment to Karnataka. The entire credit goes to Sri K.G. Jag, the Honorable Minister of Government of Karnataka. I have high regards for the senior politician and his work and government as well as in the Ministry of Transparent. I have a warm welcome to you, sir. I am also thankful to Sri J.V. Patil, additional DGFT Bangalore, for having taken time to attend this flagship event. DGFT has undertaken many procedural changes which are now online to avoid the human interference. Further reduction of the transaction cost can help exporters. A warm welcome to you, sir. I am also thankful to Sri Lakshmi Narayan, General Manager, Canara Bank, for his gracious presence. Bankers should always freely support industries. While new technology, including artificial intelligence, has entered the banks, the human touch should not be lost. In fact, we fully appreciated the efforts of Sri Raghavendra, here somewhere, Mr. Raghavendra, Manager, Canara Bank, whose personal touch has strengthened our business relationship. I request all the bank managers should follow his example. Where is Mr. Raghavendra? He's not there? Yes, Raghavendra. I am warm welcoming to Sri Lakshmi Narayan and Sri Raghavendra. Recognizing meritorious performance of our exports is very important. Through this initiative, success is lauded while the good efforts is commanded. What is extremely significant in the exporters face diverse and numerous challenges. Ever changing the trends of global markets and a host of the uncertainties to emerge successful in their business. Our initiatives of Export Excellence Award 2019 is a humble effort to recognize and award the leading exporters for their outstanding performance in different export categories. In this context, I would like to share a few ideas with all of you present here. India's exporters should focus on new markets, new products, especially sun-right products, value-added products. The three E's, electronic, electric, and engineering goods are the major sector in the world demand. We need to penetrate the world markets in these products. We also have the labor intensive and skill intensive sectors like textiles, leather manufacture, gems and jewelries, where we are the competitive and need to make further studies. Service exports are also another area where we have proven competitive. Karnataka has made the landmark automobile, agro, aerospace, textiles, garments, and heavy engineering industries. The state has sector specific SEZ for a key industries such as IT, BT, engineering, food processing, and aerospace. With the business friendly government, both state and central government and the focus on creating a state of the art is the ports. Airports, super highways and the connect in manufacturing centers to ports with the best supporting ecosystem exporters should pick up. The Make in India initiative support India's manufacturing sector together with the focus on infrastructure growth, multiple initiatives boosting exporters will also have an added benefit of strengthening our exporters. Liquidity is the biggest concern for exporters, along with their money being blocked due to various reasons. Moreover, with the China front-loading its exports recently, Indian exporters have been adversely affected in this area. RBI recent guidelines says that commercial CIBIL rating is needed for the MSMEs. Most of the MSMEs who would have the defaulted would get a bad rating. This will further lead the difficulties getting the finance from for the MSMEs. In company laws, there is also no special provision for MSMEs, so amendment is needed for this area. I'd like to make a request to Honorable Minister. Dear Sir, during the last visit of FKCCI, 26th October 2018, the matter of the requirement of occupancy certificate for getting electricity connection for getting electricity connection in respect of the HT industries was brought to the knowledge of your good selves, and also official requested has been made not to make the occupancy certificate mandatory for the HT consumer. You were kind enough to write a letter to the chairman of the KERC not to make this mandatory. However, Honorable Karnataka Electric Regulatory Commission, KERC, has amended the condition of supply COs through a notification and made it mandatory to submit occupant certificate for the serving the installation. Sir, Government of Karnataka is planning to organize the global investors meet during the January 2020 to attract the investment and enhance the economy of Karnataka. The requirement of the occupant certificate will cause the hindrance to attract the investment and further our exporters also. In the light of the above facts and circumstances, FKCCI request for a policy direction from Government of Karnataka not to make the occupant certificate is mandatory. In fact, declining exporters and labor intensive products including leather, gems and jewelries, man-made yarn of the pharmaceutical had pulled down the overall growth and outward shipments from the country. Many of these are the manufactured by the MSMEs. Exporters also facing a tough situation with the hindering the stand of US to tariffs and possibility of the global trade wars. The government needs to take a proactive stand to help exporters in these trying times. Coming to the Exports of Excellence Award, I would like to state that following the participants, be recognized, honored in the export arena by participating in the Export Excellence Award. It goes beyond winning trophies and citations. Our long-term program aims to be build a community of the exporters to support the one another and share best practices and provide the leadership. In the spirit of transparency, panel of qualified, credible judges have reviewed every submissions. Let me not to take much of your time. I wish all the export awardees more laurels in the future, and also would like to commend the spirit of the other participants, remember, success is always just an idea away. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I request our President-elect, Shri C.R. Janardhan, to introduce our guests of the evening. Please, sir.
Shri K.J. George, Honorable Minister for Large and Medium Scale Industries, Government of Karnataka. Shri J.V. Patil, ITS Additional DGFT, Bangalore. Shri Lakshmi Narayanan, General Manager, Canara Bank. Shri Sudhakar Shetty, President, FKCCI. Shri Perikal M. Sundar, Senior Vice President-elect, FKCCI. Shri K. Ravi, Immediate Past President. Shri P.V. Rai, Chairman, Export Committee. Dr. H.C. Prasad, Secretary General, past presidents and members of FKCCI, exporters, participants, including representatives from various districts and industrial associations, friends from print and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen, good evening to all. Though the Honorable Minister is familiar with everyone, it is my pleasant task to introduce again, in order to upgrade the memory of all yours. I got the pleasant task of introducing all the chief guests. Shri K.J. George. Shri George began his political career in the year 1968 when he joined the Indian National Congress. His political career started in the year 1969 when he was elected as the president of the Ganikopal Town Youth Congress. During 1971 and 72, he was the president of the Virajpet Taluk Youth Congress Committee. In the year 1975 and through 1978, he became the treasurer of the Karnataka Pradesh Youth Congress Committee. In the year 1982, he was the general secretary of the All India Youth Congress Committee, where he served till 1985, that is 3 years. He later served as the general secretary Karnataka Pradesh Congress Committee. In the year 1985, he was elected from the erstwhile Bharatinagar Assembly constituency and became an MLA. During the late 80s and early 90s, he was the Minister of State Independent Charge for the Transport, Food and Civil Supplies Departments. At present, Sri George is representing Sarvanagar constituency. During his tenure, the Bangalore Political Action Committee rated him as the best among legislators of Bangalore. At present, he is the Minister of Large and Medium Scale Industries, Government of Karnataka. Ladies and gentlemen, I got great pleasure to introduce you, Sri George, Honorable Minister. Similarly, Sri J.V. Patil, Additional DGFT, Bangalore. I am also honored to introduce Sri J.V. Patil, ITS, to this audience. Sri J.V. Patil, ITS, is presently holding the charge of Additional Director General of Foreign Trade of Bangalore office. He completed his post graduation in agriculture from University of Agriculture Science, Bangalore. He has been with the DGFT, Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, working in different capacities in various regional offices. He has been interacting with the trade and industry on issues related to international trade and implementation of foreign trade policy. He also worked as additional DGFT in the DGFT New Delhi and is now working as additional DGFT Bangalore. It gives me great pleasure to present Sri J.V. Patil, additional DGFT, to the audience. The gentleman, Mr. M. Lakshmi Narayana, I am also happy to introduce him. One more guest of honor of is our general manager, Canara Bank. Mr. Lakshmi Narayana hails from Anantapur in Andhra Pradesh. He has completed his MSc in horticulture and joined Canara Bank in the year 1984 as an agricultural extension officer in Bongir branch, Warangal district, Andhra Pradesh. Since then, he has worked in various cadres at different centers in India. He has been a versatile banker with over 34 years of progressive experience in the banking industry. He has not only been an individual achiever, but also a strong motivator, team player with effective leadership and communication skills. He has been trained from various reputed institutes such as IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bangalore, NIBM Pune, etc. on diverse business strategies and targeted areas under banking. He has also been as a faculty with Bank Staff Training Center. He has proven track record in linking corporate vision to the delivery of desired goals through good customer service and effective use of resources, processes and technologies in banking industry. He has been instrumental in loan recovery process and helping the bank to bring down its bad debt to great extent. Here I present Mr. Lakshmi Narayan to this auditorium. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for the beautiful introduction. Now we will be releasing the souvenir for FKCCI's Export Excellence Award 2019, and I request the dignitaries on the dais to do the honors. Now I request Sri N. Lakshmi Narayana, General Manager, Canara Bank, to address us all. Please, sir.
Good evening to one and all. Today's chief guest, most respected Sri K.J. George, Minister for Large and Medium Scale Industries, Government of Karnataka. J.V. Patil, Additional DGFT, Bangalore. Sudhakar Shetty, President, FKCCI. C.R. Janardana, President, Select. Perikal M. Sundar, Senior Vice President, Select. K. Ravi, Immediate Past President, and P.V. Rai, Chairman, Exports Committee. Various entrepreneurs, distinguished guests present in this August gathering, including print and media. I am happy to be part of this 14th edition of Export Excellence Award 2019, organized by Federation of Karnataka Chambers of Commerce and Industry. All of us, we know, exports play an important role in accelerating the economic growth of our country. Members of FICCI contributed significantly for increased exports in the state of Karnataka, and definitely a good source of income from this group. Karnataka state is blessed with good nature, rich in natural resources, availability of tech-savvy and innovative people. People are here very, very innovative. Our bank is fortunate to have its headquarters in Bangalore, opened in 1906 by Sri Amempal Subbarao Pai. In a small way, is now one of the leading PSUs in India with a total business of 10.43 lakh crores, a deposits base of 5.99 lakh crores, and advances of 4.43 lakh crores. We got 6,315 branches, and we also got international presence, having branches at London, New York, Moscow, etc. Our net NPA, drastically we could able to reduce it to 5.37% in the recently concluded financial results, and we got strong capital base of 11.90. Bangalore circle is one of the biggest circle in our bank, from where I am representing, and we got 1,45,000 crore business, and we are catering to the needs of various clients, let it be corporate, retail, and MSME and other exporters. Our bank's total foreign business turnover for March 19 stood at 2,57,000 crores, of which exports alone 1.25 lakh crores. And we got, our Bangalore circle contributes 53% of our bank's exports, that is 55,000, and 40% of our bank's imports. Really, thanks to all of you who are passing sizable business through our bank, directly or indirectly, and my sincere thanks to you all, sir. We got international treasury wing at Mumbai, and we got in every state foreign departments, overseas branches, IF and specialized SME branches. Really, our seniors Definitely they had a forethought, opened SME branches in every industrial cluster, let it be Peenya, Mahadevpura, Bamsandra, and even whatever upcoming centers also, we are having idea to open more and more branches, and including that near airport, a big industrial layout is there, and many industries are coming up there also. We got lot of schemes to serve the needs of exporters and especially MSME parties. We are in the advanced stage of implementing a centralized processing center for forex transactions, which will be single point access to forex business for customers to reduce the turnaround time. We offer the following facilities: pre-shipment credit, both Indian and foreign currencies; post-shipment by way of discounting of bills, both in Indian rupees and foreign currency; interest rate as low as 4.2% for MSME units where you are claiming 5% interest subvention from GOI. We arrange foreign currency loans, open foreign LCs for import of raw material or goods, facilitates customers to hedge their foreign exposure by booking forward contracts, and ECGC premium for post-shipment credit is entirely absorbed by our bank. Also assist our export customers to take buyer's wise policy at competitive premium from ECGC. Some of the initiatives done by our Government of India for betterment of MSE exports are interest equalization on pre-shipment and post-shipment rupee export credits of 5% to all eligible MSE units, including food and agro units; 2% interest subvention scheme for fresh bar incremental loans up to 1 crore under MSME, and PSB loans in 59 minutes, which is a digital platform to get in-principle sanction of 5 lakhs to 1 crore loan. And recently, Government of India introduced even TREDS also, Trade Receivables Discounting System. This is online discounting of bills, an electronic trade platform, and it is right now available in our industrial finance branch, Infant Road, Bangalore. And Made in India, my earlier speakers have already mentioned about it. Promotion of ease of doing business is also being attempted by us. Improved availability of credit through Mudra and Stand Up India schemes are also being implemented, and we got sizable number of loans given. And Government of India also has introduced MEIS, Merchandise Exports from India scheme, a major export promotion scheme of GOI for incentivizing export of specified goods for specified markets. Service exports from India scheme under foreign trade policy, that is from 1/4/2015 to 31/3/2020, provides facility of duty-free scrips at the rate of 3% or 5% on their net foreign exchange earnings, which are transferable, can be used for payment of central duties, taxes, including custom duty. Export promotion capital goods scheme and financial support to MSMEs in ZED certification scheme, that is zero defect and zero effects. Friends, our country is aiming target of $100 billion exports by 2020. The requirement is integrating MSME into a global value chain is the need of the hour. I am sure with better infrastructure support from various agencies, coupled with adequate and timely credits from banks and other financial institutions, certainly our country, our state can do wonders, and definitely we can earn a lot of foreign exchange to our country. And before concluding my speech, a few points from clientele point of view. You strengthen your financial statements, and now it is a transparent era. See that you put your transactions through the bank accounts, so that when it comes for renewal with enhancement, definitely we can consider. And now rating is the criteria. Please see that you are complying with the rating requirements. Ensure that your account is rated as low risk or normal risk, because our delegation of powers are linked to, including my powers are linked to the rate. If risk rating is very low, I got more powers. If it is high risk, sometimes I don't have power. I have to send it to my MD and CEO. So friends, now all of you are aware of, some of you are dealing with banks even more than my service. I got 34 years service I put in. Some of the entrepreneurs have got almost 40 years dealings with the banks. You know the rules. So you project your credit report properly, ensure that you get your good assessment and conduct transactions properly. Definitely we are there to take care of you. And I have told by in one of the meetings by somebody, there are three friends in life. One friend, all our assets, that is your site, your building, your gold ring, everything, it will vanish the moment we die. It is not belonging to yours. Second is your friends, relatives and your dependents, all of them will come to our graveyard, afterwards they will vanish. You will lose that second friend. But whatever good things we do in our life, definitely that will carry to our eternal life. So all of us, during our tenure, see that not only, yes, it is my primary duty to take care of my kin and kith, but at the same time, when I got capacity, try to help as many citizens of this country as possible and see that our fellow brothers also have got their bread and butter with better living conditions, so that we will be homogeneous in our living conditions, and definitely India is going to grow to a greater heights and will be number one in the world. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Sri J.V. Patil, ITS, Additional DGFT, Bangalore, to address us all.
Today's chief guest, Honorable Sri K.J. George, Honorable Minister for Large and Medium Industries, Government of Karnataka, Sri Sudhakar Shetty, President, FKCCI, Sri Janardhan, President-elect, FKCCI, Sri Perikar Sundar, Senior Vice President-elect, Sri P.V. Rai, Chairman Export Committee, and Sri Ravi, past President, and the H.S.C. Prasad, Secretary General of FKCCI, and all senior members from the FKCCI, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great opportunity to be here on this day. I thank the FKCC for giving me this opportunity to be part of this event. And also I congratulate FKCCI for holding this event continuously, which is very important to encourage and sustain our exports. I take this opportunity to congratulate all who have participated in this award submission competition and who have been succeeded. Even a dollar earned is a pride for us. So it is not the amount of how much foreign exchange an exporter earns. It's the how he earns, what it impact it has. Because I have come across many companies may be having 1,000 crores, but a small cottage industry doing a 10 crore also, it has an immense impact on the Indian economy in terms of the pride, in terms of their livelihood, impacts in the overall economy. So the India's exports is a very critical component of the economy, not in terms of just foreign exchange. It's a part, you have to be part of the global value chain. It brings a pride in you, it brings a competitiveness in you, you absorb the new technology, so which is very critical in terms of a broad this one. So from that point of view, this encouragement, recognition is a very long step, which I appreciate the FKCCI. As you know, the Karnataka state is one of the most diversified, most beautiful, but even in the export scene, if you have many of the states, if I see, you know, they export in particular one commodity, two commodities, but Karnataka has been, it has been earlier, has been traditionally exporting coffee, spices, handicrafts, silk, but it has come long way. We are into the engineering, ready-made garments, and value-added products, agriculture products. So it's much larger basket, most diversified, not just goods. As you see, in India has now achieved 331 billion, a positive note as far as this year is concerned. For the last, from 2011 onwards, we have been seeing it's around 300, and only in 1 year it crossed 314, but in this year, 18-19, we touched 331, registering a growth of nearly 9% over the previous year. On this positive note, we need to see the potential because and harness further. So from that point of view, when I see Karnataka has been when we look at the exports, we just don't look at only the goods, it's also services. So it is, in fact, the Ministry of Commerce has taken up the champions of service sectors for promotion of service exports. And even in that, the Karnataka takes the pride. It is not just the IT export services, it has the education service, hospitality service, research and development, it's a knowledge hub, and which is a traditionally the strength of Bangalore and surrounding of the Karnataka, surrounding cities within the Karnataka, has been able to synergize. This synergy we need to take forward, because you would have seen even the aerospace industry is one of the important growth area which is coming up, which we can tap into. In fact, the growth in exports, engineering has been one of the major contributor, and in that way you can say the Karnataka has been major partner in that. So we, as a in the service also, we have education, we have a biotechnology area, we have a hospitality, and we have the engineering embedded services, we have design services. So you name it, we have across, and in that way, so it's a one. It's an important state which is doing well, which has a great potential for taking it further. In the DGFT, we have been providing to exporters a lot of under the schemes for promotion of exports. We provide raw material without duty, for that you can manufacture and export. We provide capital goods at a zero duty so that you can set up a manufacturing and further undertake exports. Apart from this, we have an incentive scheme called Merchant Export Incentive Scheme, wherein we provide at 2-3% or up to 7% of your FOB value, which can be used to make the payment of the duty. And in addition to this, DGFT has taken a number of initiatives so that it's online, you have a ease of doing it business. Earlier, for import-export code, you have to come and apply to the search, where is the office, which application I make, which photograph I paste, everything. Now it is just 10 minutes. You just apply online with your checkbook and with your details. Immediately you get the I-code certificate online from the DGFT site. So anywhere in the part of the country, you can obtain your I-code without visiting the office. And in terms of for the duty-free importer, you used to provide licenses, which used to be hard copy, which used to be signed and sent it across to you, which you have to carry to customs. Even that has been dispensed with. All the import certificates, including MEIs, are all online. You don't have to get it from the office. The moment you make an application, it comes back to you. So even for MEIs, which is issued post-exports based on shipping bill and bank certificate, you don't have to submit any of these physical copies. It's the banks upload the EBRCs of realization on the DGFT site. Customs forward the shipping bill to the DGFT site, both of you, that to be attached and submitted to the office, and immediately the MEIs for that particular value is transmitted back. I know that what schemes we provide, what this facility we provide, it itself cannot promote the exports. The major has to happen in the manufacturing, in the local, in the with support of the state governments, and the DGFT has been, Ministry of Commerce has taken a number of steps to partner with the state for a promotion of the exports, for taking the manufacturing into the parks. In terms of that, in fact, from Ministry of Commerce wrote to the state governments to have exclusive organization dealing with exports, and also committee chaired by the Chief Secretary for the exports. In fact, in that way, I can say even before these steps, Karnataka has been in the forefront from the over the large years. I have been seeing they always had an exclusive organization for exports. The VTPC is one of the vibrant body which is helps for the exports, and also we have already a functioning state level export promotion committee chaired by the Chief Secretary. From that point of view, we have already a very systematic, what we need is to take it to the interiors. For the exports, we need to identify districts who can be potential. It has to become a way of life, it has to become our culture. When I say this, I am not pessimistic, I am optimistic for some of the reasons which I can say. One lady came to me just to inquire that she wants to export candle made of ghee. She was struggling, how do I export, because she has a it's one clearance problem because of the air cargo, airport handling instructions. But very fact, a lady striving on her own to export a particular commodity, that itself shows the interest export many individuals have. And we have a, we conduct a Niryat program, Niryat Bandhu program that's called, which is for new budding exporters. In just other day, I was, to my surprise, we just sent about nearly more than 500 emails. We did not send any letter, we did not make any announcement, just an email to the exporters, please come and attend the Niryat Bandhu program. To my surprise, 70 people turned up within 2 days' notice. So that is the level of interest people have. I think we need to nurture this and take it forward. And I'm sure there are many budding, I've seen from Chalakere, there are husband and wife promoting agriculture exports. And a number of examples. I went to Bijapur, there is a lady who visited more than 40-50 countries, exports Lombardi's ladies made handbags, which she has an exclusive website from a remote corner of a state, which is a backward district. So that is, and I, one more example I quote, which I feel optimistic that we can increase the exports, that I came across a boy, he came to our office that he wanted to export. I said, you attend our program. Then he said, he is from a trader in a Badgi. Their fathers were traditionally trading in the Badgi chilies. He's an MBA graduate. Then he said, why can't I export? Then he entered, he did it. First consignment, he struggled in Bombay. He said he had a lot of problem with spices board clearance, certification and all. But finally he succeeded. Then he entered the exports. So what I'm saying is, we have an optimism. I'm sure with the state government support, sir has come all the way to give you prizes. That shows the indication level of commitment we have. Sir, it's a great inspiration for you being here. So I'm sure we'll take it forward with, and I'm assure you that we get into the interiors of the district. Each general manager of the district industries department will interact and get the more people to get into the exports and the logistics related, because I said it's not the just procedure, it is not just manufacturing facility, it is also the logistics. The Department of Commerce has an exclusive logistics department. They have been interacting with the state governments to take up the logistic related issues if there is anything through the exports for, and we need to identify the sectors and we need to build a, this is the, we are there, why can't I grow? Because even if you see our export basket, it is limited to certain countries, limited to certain commodities. There is a huge potential we need to tap. For that, even though our embassies are ready to be partner with us, we need to find out the markets, which are the countries which they are importing from other countries, not from us. Why? So that we need to ask questions and then increase our basket. It is, I always say that it's not that you do suddenly 1,000 crores. You do a 10 crore, 90 crore maybe domestic market, still it boosts you, it boosts in all respects for the Indian economy. From that point of view, I'm sure, so this event is an inspiration to each one of you who are here with exports, awards, you're an inspiration to the other surrounding people. So let us build as a way of life, with a culture, as a passion, just like how the Khadi was. So then we can increase our exports. If a small country can do much more than us, why not us, who are technically advanced, we have all the resources, we have diversified products. I am sure we can be a part of the global value chain. Let us reduce our dependence on imports, which are substitutes, so reduce our trade deficit, further our exports, and take it forward for the Indian economy and the state prosperity also. So with these words, I congratulate all of you. I congratulate FKCC for doing this and give me an opportunity. And I thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir, for encouraging our exporters. Now I would request our chief guest of the evening, Shri K.J. George, Honorable Minister for Large and Medium Industries, Government of Karnataka, to address us all.
Hello, Namaskara. Iyondo award winning presentation sabhege bandirthakanta nanna sneehituru mattu FKCCI chairman rada Sudhakar Shetty avare namore ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಹುಬ್ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಅವರು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಅವರು ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಡಿ ಜಿ ಎಫ್ ಟಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರು ನಾನು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಬಟ್ ಅವ್ರ ವಿಚಾರ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಬಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಮಾತು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಡಿ ಜಿ ಎಫ್ ಟಿ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮೀನಾರಾಯಣ ಅವರು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ರಾ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರ್ ನನಗೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ರಾ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಸಂಬಂಧ ನಮ್ಮ ರತ್ನಾಕರ ರಾಯ್ ಅವರು ಚೇರ್ಮನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು ಎಂ ಡಿ ಅವರು ಚೇರ್ಮನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಸ್ ನನಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಡಿ ಜಿ ಎಫ್ ಟಿ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಆ ಕಾಲದಿಂದ ಇತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಸಮೇತ ಅವರು ವಿಚಾರ ಹೇಳಿದರು ಭಾರಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರು ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟರು ನಾನು ತಮಾಷೆ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಹೌದು ಅವರಿಬ್ಬರು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ಕರೆಸಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದರೆ ಕರೆಸ್ತಾನೆ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಜನಾರ್ದನ್ ಅವರು ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಅವರಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಪೆರಿಕಲ್ ಸುಂದರ್ ಅವರು ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ವೈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಅವರು ರವಿ ಅವರು ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಸಾದ್ ಅವರು ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಜನರಲ್ ಅವರು ಮತ್ತು ಹಾನರರಿ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲರ್ಸ್ ನಮಗೇನು ಅಂತಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವರೇ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಈಗ ಈಗ ಸುಮಾರು 24 ಜನ ಓನರ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಮತ್ತು 7 ಜನ ಇದು ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲರ್ಸ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನನ್ನೇನು ಸಮೇತ ನನ್ನ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಇವರು ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮೇರಿಕನ್ ಯು ಎಸ್ ಚೆನ್ನೈಯಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲ್ ಜನರು ಅವರು ಸಮೇತ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಭಾರಿ ಪ್ರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿನ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಅವರೇ ಮುಖ್ಯ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ಪಾಪ ಅವ್ರ ಸ್ವಂತ ಇದರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಕೆಲವರು ನನಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೀವು ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಡಿ ನಮಗೆ ತೊಂದರೆ ಕೊಡಬೇಡಿ ನಮಗೇನು ತೊಂದರೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ರು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲು ತಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಐ ಟಿ ಬಿ ಟಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆದಾಗ ಈ ಐ ಟಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಾನು ಆಗ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೆ 89-90 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಸಿಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಎಸ್ ಎಂ ಪಟ್ನಾಯಕರು ಅವರು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಚೇರ್ಮನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು ಅವರು ನನಗೆ ಬಂದು ಹೇಳುವರು ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಅದು ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು 35,000 ಜನ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರು ಏಕೆ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗೋಕೆ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆಯೇ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಏನಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಿತ್ತು ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಿತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಐ ಟಿ ಬಿ ಟಿ ಅವರು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಯಿತು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮದು ಆಫೀಸರ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕಟ್ಟೋದು ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ರು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು ಬಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಏನಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಫೈಲ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಕೇಸ್ ವರ್ಕರು ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರು ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ರಿ ಡೆಪ್ಯೂಟಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ರಿ ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ರಿ ದೆನ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತನಕ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾನೆಲ್ಲ ಫೈಲ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ ಆ ಕೇಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಏನು ಬರೆದ ಅವನೇ ಆತರು ಅವನೇನು ಬರ್ದು ಬಾಕಿಯವ್ರನ್ನ ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಿಗ್ನೇಚರ್ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ ಬಟ್ ಅದು ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು 2 ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಕ್ವೇರಿ ಹಾಕಿದರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅದು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟಿಂದ ಏನಾದರೂ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮುಗೀತು ಫೈಲ್ ಖಾತೆ ಆ ಥರ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಬೇರೆ ಒಂದು ಭಾಳ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇದೆ ಬಟ್ ಈಗೆಲ್ಲ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಈಗ ಇ ಗವರ್ನೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಈಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ಮುಂದೆ ಬರೋ ದಿವಸಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ಫುಲ್ಲು ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆಂಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಈಗದ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ ಸಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಜನ್ರೇಷನಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಇಂಟರ್ನೆಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರು ಬುಕ್ ಓದಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಒಂದು ಬುಕ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಥವಾ ಬುಕ್ ಲೈಬ್ರರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಈಗ ಆ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒನ್ ದ ಫಿಂಗರ್ ಟಿಪ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಟರ್ನೆಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಡೀ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಏ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದು ಈ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಈಗ ಯೂತ್ಸ್ ಇದಾರಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ರೆವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ಟೈಪ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಈಗ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಪ್ಸು ಇಡೀ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮೇಡ್ ಎ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಬ್ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಧಾರವಾಡ ಆಗಲಿ, ಬೆಳಗಾಂ ಆಗಲಿ, ಮೈಸೂರು ಆಗಲಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪವರ್ ಎಂಜಿನ್. ಆದರೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಇದು ತುಮಕೂರು, ಈಗ ತಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತದ್ದು ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಟೌನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಮಿಷನ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸು, ಜಾಪಾನೀಸು, ಇದು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಈಗ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ದಟ್ ನಾವು ಮತ್ತು ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೇರ್ವೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಭಾಳ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಕೊಡುವಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಮೊದಲು ಈ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಟೌನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬರೀ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಬರೀ ಶೆಡ್ಗಳೇ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ನಮ್ಮದೇ ಒಂದು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇದೆ ಕುಶಾಲನಗರದಲ್ಲಿ, ಹೋಗಿ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಯಾಕಪ್ಪ ಅದೊಂದು ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ರೂಮ್ ಆದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಶೆಡ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಅನುಮತಿ ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ರು. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಒಂದು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಶೆಡ್ ಇದಾವಂಗೆ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾರೋ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಒಂದು ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೂಮ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಅದು ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಯಾಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಅದನ್ನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಕೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದೇ ಈಗ ನನಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಾಗಿ ಅನುಭವ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಈಗ ಅದನ್ನು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಆಕ್ಯುಪೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ವಿಚಾರ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ನಾನು ಲೆಟ್ರ್ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಈಗ ಇರೋ ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಹೊಸ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಏನು ಆಕ್ಯುಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್? ಅವ್ರೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ಶೆಟ್ರು, ಹಳೇದು ಹಿಂದುಗಡೆ ಇರೋದು ಕೊಡ್ಬೋದು. ಅದು ನಾವು ನೀವು ಕೂತು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಷಣ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ, ನಾನು ಕಲ್ಗಡೆ ಇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ. ಈ ಥರ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ನಮಗೆ ರಾಜಕಾರಣಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂದರೆ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಫಾಲೋ ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಥರ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಡ. ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಗಳ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತೀನಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಕೂತು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ರೂಮಲ್ಲೇ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಭಾಷಣ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನು ಬೇಡ. ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಕೂತು ಆ ಕಡೆ ಕಡೆ ಕೂತು ನಾವು ಸೆಟ್ಲ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಮತ್ತು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಮತ್ತು ನೀವು FKCCI ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಹಾರಾಜರು ಈಗ ನಾವು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನೆನಪಿಗೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಹೂವು ಹಾಕಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡು ಬಹುಶಃ ನೀವೇ ಅದೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟರು, ನಮ್ಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡಿದೆ, ನಮಗೆ ತಿಂಗಳು ತಿಂಗಳು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇವ್ರು ನೀವು ಅದೃಷ್ಟವಂತರು ಅಂತ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಭಾರಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ವಿಶ್ವೇಶ್ವರಯ್ಯ ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಹುಶಃ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಅವತ್ತಿನ ಸತಿಯಾಗಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸು ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವೇನಾದರೂ ಭಾರತ ದೇಶ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಇದು ರ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, GDP ಗ್ರೋತ್ಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಇಡೀ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಭಾರತ ದೇಶನೇ ಯಂಗ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ಯಾವಾಗ ಯಂಗ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಯುರೋಪ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಮೇರಿಕಾ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಜಪಾನ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಚೈನಾ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಯಾವಾಗ ಯಂಗ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಇರುವ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಇಂಜಿನ್. ಈಗೇನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಈಗ ನಾವೇನಾದ್ರು ಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ 20-25 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ನು ಏಜ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪುಷ್. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಜನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಇದಿರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಾಗಿ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಥಿಯೇಟಿಕಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು. ನಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲಿಯಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಜಾಬಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಳೆದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರು. ಇದು ಎಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ, ಯಾವುದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ. ಈಗ ನೀವು ಹೋಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಜಾಬ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ತಾನೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಈಗ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟು 6 months 1 year ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆ ಇದೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಇವತ್ತು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆಶಯನದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್, ಇವತ್ತು ನನ್ನ ವಿಚಾರ ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ, ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನೀವು ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೇತ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಕುಮಾರಸ್ವಾಮಿಯವರು ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಪಾಪ ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಅವರು ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು, ಯಾವುದು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಡನ್. ಇದು ನಮಗೇನಂದ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ವೆದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅವರ್ಸು. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಜಿಂಡಾದ ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಟ್ರವರ್ಸಿ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಅದು ಏಕೆ ಕಾಂಟ್ರವರ್ಸಿ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಲ್ಲ ಏಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಸೆವೆಂಟಿ ಒನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅವರು ಅಕ್ವೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಏನನ್ಸಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ 9,000 ಇದು ಎಕರೆನೇ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಮಾಡೋರು ಇಂದಿರಾ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವ್ರ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ. ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದು 94 ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೊಟ್ಟು ನೀವು 6 ವರ್ಷ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಸನ್ಮಾನ್ಯ ದೇವೇಗೌಡರವರು ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು, ಸನ್ಮಾನ್ಯ ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯನವರು ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಡೆಪ್ಯೂಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರು 3,500 ಎಕರೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸುಮಾರು 40,000 ಏನೋ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, 40,000 ಎಕರೆಗೆ ಅಂದಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ನಂಬುದನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಇದು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಡೀಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದು ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಡೀಡ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನಾವು ಲೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಫುಲ್ಫಿಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ನಾವು ಕೊಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದನ್ನು 3,500 ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ಸಿಲರಿ ಯೂನಿಟಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ 500 ಅದು ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ. 2004-05 ಅವತ್ತು ಧರ್ಮಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರು ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು, ಇವರಿಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅರ್ಜಿ ಹಾಕಿದರು. ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯನವರು ಡೆಪ್ಯೂಟಿ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು. ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದರೆ 2,000 acres ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೊಡುವಾಗ 90,000 ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ನಾನು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸಾರಿ ಯಾಕಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕೆ ತಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕು ಏನಂದಿಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯಾಕಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ 90,000 ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಕೊಟ್ಟಾದಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಆರ್ಡ್ರ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕುಮಾರಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅವರು ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು, ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪನವರು ಡೆಪ್ಯೂಟಿ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು. ನಾನು ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ದೇವೇಗೌಡರು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯನವರು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕುಮಾರಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅವರು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ, ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪನವರು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಒಂದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಮಾತ್ರ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಸೇಲ್. ಮತ್ತೆ 1,600 acres ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಸಮೇತ ಸುಮಾರು 125,000 ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಸಮೇತ ಲೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಸೇಲ್. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮೊದಲು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಇಂಡಿಯಾಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಇನ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಲೆವೆಲಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೇತ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ಇವತ್ತು ತಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಇದೊಂದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನಡೀತಾರೆ. ಅವರು ಅದನ್ನು ಫುಲ್ಫಿಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಯಾರೊಬ್ಬರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಯಾವುದು ಮೈಸೂರು ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್, ನಾನು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಲ್ಲ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ಅವ್ರು ಯಾವ ಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್. ಅವರು JSW ಅವರೊಂದು ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ MML ಅವರು ಇದೊಂದು ಕೌಂಟರ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದು ಕೋರ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ. ಅದು ಕೋರ್ಟ್ ಜಡ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ MML ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ MML ಅವರು ರಿಕವರಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವರೇನು ಓಡಿ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. 50,000 crore ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, 25,000 ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, 7,000 crore ಅಷ್ಟು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಂಥ ವಿಚಾರ ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ವಿಚಾರ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಅವ್ರು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬೆಳೆಯಲಿ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬರಲಿ ಅಂದಿಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಉದ್ದೇಶ ನಮಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಐ ಸಪೋರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ರೂವ್. ಇವತ್ತು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಇದನ್ನು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಏನಂದಿಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನಿದೆ. ನಂದು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬಿಡ್ಜದೊಂದು ಬಂತು, ನಾನು ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರು ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್. ಏನು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬಿಡ್ಜು ಜನ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಯಾವ ತೋರಿಸಿಕೊಟ್ರು. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದಲ್ಲ, ರೈಲ್ವೆ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ತದಲ್ಲ, ಯಾರೋ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಬಿಟ್ರು ಆ ಥರ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್. ಇವತ್ತು ಹೆಬ್ಬಾಲು ನೀವೇನಾದರೂ ಹೋಗಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ, ನಾನು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಬಾಟಲ್ನೆಕ್. ಅದನ್ನು ತಪ್ಪಿಸಬೇಕು. ಈಗ ಇದೊಂದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ದಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಸಮೇತ ಏನಂದಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ವಿರೋಧ. ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ವಿರೋಧ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದರೆ ನೀವು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಜಾಮು. ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಜಾಮ್ ಆದರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮೇನ್ ಡೇಸ್. ಇವತ್ತು ಏನಾದರೂ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ಕಾಗೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆದರೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರುವಾಗ ಆಗಲಿ, ಭಿನ್ನಾಭಿಪ್ರಾಯ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಪ್ರೊಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಬರಲಿ. ನಾನು ಅದರ ಇದು ಏನು ಸದಾನಗೌಡರಿಗೆ ಅವತ್ತು ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಅವರು ನನ್ನ ಒಪ್ಪಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದರು, ಯಾಕೆ ಅವ್ರ ಕಾನ್ಶಿಯನ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲಾಗಿ ಬೇರೆ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಆ ಥರ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ರಾಜಕೀಯ ಪಕ್ಷಗಳು ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಆದರೆ ಜನರ ಒಂದು ಹಿತಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಅವು ಅದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಯಾವುದೇ ಟೀಕೆ ಬರಲಿ ಡ್ರಮ್. ಬಟ್ ಫೈನಲಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಚುನಾಯಿತ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ಆಗಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಒಪ್ಪಲೇಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಯಾಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ನಾಮಿನೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬರದೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಮಗೇನೋ ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟು ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆದರೆ ನಾಳೆ ಯಾರು ಅದನ್ನು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂಲಿಂದ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರವಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೇತ ನಾವು ಇವತ್ತು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಆಶಿನ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೇತ ತಾವು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರ. ಇವತ್ತು ಈ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ನಮಗೇನಾಯಿತು, ನಾನು ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಂದಮೇಲೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಂತು. ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ 4 ನಮ್ಮದೆಲ್ಲ ಅಡ್ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದರು ಎಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ 4 ನಾವೇನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಕೂತು ನಾವು ನೀವು ಯಾಕೆಂದಿಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸ. ನೀವು ಮನಸ್ಸು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಹೊರತು ನೀವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಡೀ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ಟು ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ನಾನು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್. ನಾವು ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಸಮೇತ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಿಮ್ದು ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ವಾಟ್ರದ್ದು ಸಮೇತ ವಾಟರ್ ರೇಟ್ ಸಮೇತ ಮೊನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಈಗ ಒಪ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಇವರು ಮೇಜರ್ ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಶಿವಕುಮಾರ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡುವ ಅವರು ಒಪ್ಪಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆದಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗನೆ ವಾಟರ್ ರೇಟ್ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮೇತ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಸಹಾಯವನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸಿದ್ಧರಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಎಂಬ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿ, ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ದ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿತ್. ಇವತ್ತು ಬರೀ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಸಮೇತ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಆಲ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್. ವೆರಿ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಳಗಾಂ, ಅವರು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಏರೋಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್, ಮಿಷನ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಇದು ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ಕೋರ್ಟ್ ಇದರಿಂದ ಕೆಲವರು ತಪ್ಪು ಮಾಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನ ತಪ್ಪು ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇವತ್ತು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ದು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಮಿಲ್ಸ್ ಬರಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಮೈಂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ತುಂಬ ಇದೆ, ಗಾರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಅವರು ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಕಷ್ಟ ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನ ಅವರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಪಿಯೂಷ್ ಗೋಯಲ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅವರು ನಾಳೆದು ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಅವರು ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅವರು ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಈಗ ಒಂದು ವಾರ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹೋಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಮಾತಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನಿದ್ದರೂ ಸಮೇತ ನಾವು ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಸೇರಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿ, ಬಹುಶಃ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮವನಾಗಿ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ ಎಂಬ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿಕೊಂಡು ನನಗೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟು ತಮ್ಮನ್ನು ವಂದಿಸಿ ನಾನು ಮಾತಾಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಜೈ ಹಿಂದ್, ಜೈ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ.
Now the wait is over. We are moving on to the presentation of Export Excellence Award.
Karnataka Vanijya Mattu Kaigarika Mahasamsthe, Federation of Karnataka Chambers of Commerce and Industry. 14th edition of Export Excellence Awards 2019. Exporter Award category Manufacturer, and the winner is Himat Singh Car Seeder Limited. Exporter Award category Merchant, and the winner is Rajesh Exports Limited. Star Exporter Award category Services, and the winner is Cisco Systems India Private Limited. Manufacturer Export Award category Large, and the gold winner is Toyota Kirloskar Motor Private Limited. Manufacturer Export Award category Large, and the silver winner is Meditic Limited and Mini Precision Products Limited. Manufacturer Export Award, category medium. And the gold winner is Mukka Seafood Industries Private Limited. Manufacturer Export Award, category medium. And the silver winner is InCap Contract Manufacturing Services Private Limited and Buildmet Fibers Private Limited.
Silver InCap Contract Manufacturing Services Private Limited and Buildmet Fibers Private Limited for the Best Manufacturer Export Award, Silver.
Manufacturer Export Award, category small. And the gold winner is Green Camp. Manufacturer Export Award, category small. And the silver winner is Deccan Hydraulics Private Limited. Manufacturer Export Award, category micro. And the gold winner is Jai Keshav Exports Private Limited. Manufacturer Export Award, category micro. And the silver winner is Savitri Sugandhalaya. Edition of Export Excellence Awards 2019. Best Merchant Export Award. And the gold winner is Mysore Mercantile Co. Limited. Best Merchant Export Award. And the silver winner is Ultimate Branding Worldwide and Yes Anandan and Co. excluding software, exporter award. And gold winner is GE India Industrial Private Limited. Best Software Exporter Award. And gold winner is DR Systems Private Limited. District Export Awards. Bagalkot District winner is Godavari Bio Refineries Limited. District Export Awards. Belgaum District winner is REC Flow Technologies LLP. Best District Export Awards. Bellary District winner is Sri Raghavendra Enterprises. Best District Export Awards. Bengaluru Rural and the winner is Texco Factions. District Export Awards. Bijapur District winner is Star Fruit Company. Best District Export Awards. Chamarajanagara District winner is BG Granites. Best District Export Awards. Chikkabalapur District winner is Satvik Foods Private Limited. District Export Awards. Chitradurga District winner is Shri Ganesh Exime. District Export Awards. Dakshina Kannada District winner is Big Bats Private Limited. District Export Awards. Davangere District winner is Green Agro Park Private Limited. District Export Awards. Dharwad District winner is KEN Agritech Private Limited. Best District Export Awards. Haveri District winner is Synthite Industries Private Limited. Best District Export Awards. Kodagu District winner is Net Commodities India Private Limited. District Export Awards. Kolar District winner is Varga Attachments Private Limited. Best District Export Awards. Mandya District winner is Greens Food Crafts India Private Limited. Best District Export Awards. Mysore District winner is KAR Enterprises. District Export Awards. Raichur District winner is Shilpa Medicare Limited. Best District Export Awards. Ramanagara District winner is Toyota Kirloskar Auto Parts Private Limited. Best District Export Awards. Tumakur District winner is Tadi Mitti Aromatics Private Limited. District Export Awards. Udupi District winner is Pola Raghavendra Kamat and Sons. Best District Export Awards. Uttar Kannada District winner is Prakriti Products Private Limited. Best Export Award in Special Category Gold, and the winner is KWK Resistors India Private Limited. Exporter Award from More or Most Backward District. And the winner is Kum International's Chamarajanagara. Export Award. And the winner is Blue Line Foods India Private Limited. Special Award for the Best Export Facilitation Organization. And the winner is Director General of Foreign Trade. Special Award for the Best Financial Institution. And the winner is Canara Bank. FKCCI acknowledges the support of Diamond Sponsor Canara Bank, Co-Sponsors New Mangalore Port Trust, Deutsche Bank, ECGC, Citibank.
I request Kumar Anshuman sir to please come and collect the award. Our co-sponsor Deutsche Bank and also Citibank. I request all the sponsors to please come onto the stage. Bank. Thank you for supporting us. Of course, choosing the winner was not an easy task, and we appreciate our jury team for helping us doing this. I request Madam Soma Chaudhary from FIO, Deputy Director and Karnataka Head, to please come on to the dais. Kumar Anshuman from ECGC. Mr. Mohan Suresh, Honorary Consul of Rwanda. Mr. J.V. Patil, of course we have our dignitary on the dais. And Dr. Anup Dayanand Sadhu, IRTS Group General Manager. Mr. Ravi Kumar from NSIC and S.R. Satisha, MDVTPC. request Shri Perikal M. Sundar, Senior Vice President Elect FKCCI, to please present the vote of thanks.
Ellarigu namaskara. K.K. George, Minister of Large and Medium Scale Industry, Government of Karnataka. Mr. J.V. Patil, Additional DGFT, Bangalore. Mr. N. Lakshmi Narayan, General Manager, Canara Bank. Mr. Sudhakar Shetty, President, FKCCI. Mr. C.R. Janardhan, President-elect, FKCCI. Mr. K. Ravi, Immediate Past President. Mr. P.V. Rai, Chairman, Export Committee, FKCCI. Dr. K. Prasad, Secretary General, FKCCI, Past President and members of FKCCI, distinguished invitees, juries members, award winners and friends from print and electronic media. Good evening. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks to the dignitaries of this program for having graced the occasion and spared their valuable time for the awarding the Export Excellency Award to the exporters of Karnataka. The first and foremost, our sincere thanks and gratitude to Sri K.K. George, Minister of Large and Medium Scale Industry, Government of Karnataka, for accepting our invitation to be a chief guest and awarding the Exporters Excellence Award and addressing the enlightening the gathering in spite of his busy schedule. Thank you, sir. We extend our sincere gratitude to Sri J.V. Patil, Additional DGFT, Bangalore, and Sri Lakshmi Narayan, General Manager, Canara Bank, our guest of honor for accepting grace this program with the presence. On behalf of FKCCI, I would like to thank our diamond sponsor, Canara Bank, for their support. I would like to thank co-sponsor, New Bangalore Port Trust, Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India, Deutsche Bank and City Bank for extending their valuable support for this event. My sincere thanks to jury members for sparing their time scrutinizing the each and every application and choosing the winner. I also thanks to advertisers who have supported by us publishing their advertisement in the 7 years. It is my pleasure to thank all the exporters and awardees for their active participation. I congratulate the awardees for their achievement and wishes them to best in the future endeavors. I request to awardees who was not FKCCI members yet to become a members of the FKCCI, which I am sure will be of mutual benefit. I thanks to all the president, members of managing committee members, FKCCI members, secretaries, exporters, invitees and officials from central and state government, trade promotion bodies and FIO Mrs. Soma Chowdhury for their gracious presence today. I thanks to press and electromedia for their wonderful support and cooperation for this event. My special thanks to P.V. Rai, Chairman Export Committee, for taking this lead the organization program with the support. Leading in the organization of this program with the support of Secretariat, including Ms. Tanushri, Secretary, and Umesh Maduwala, Deputy Secretary, and all the staff of FKCCI working the hard to make this event grand success. I thanks each and everyone to being with us, making this event a memorable success. Thank you, one and all.